Hello everybody and welcome to Dark DJ Productions, and today we're doing another driver experience course with DR1202. And today, as you can probably tell from the livery and the thumbnail, we are going to be doing it with Mr. James Wright. Hello, James.
Hello.
And welcome back to the Hello Files. In this video, we're going to have just me and James because we want it to be a bit more of a personal experience. So, as you can see, we've got DR1202 Rick in LNER livery with lots of LNER coaches, and James wants to drive over the Customs Railway. So we're going to be going from here at Wimborne over to Brockenhurst, and then we're probably going to do a little bit of mainline just as a bit of extra so James can have a feel for the power of this thing on the mainline. So James will be driving, I will be firing. So without further ado, I'm going to take my hands off the keyboard for a moment and show James messing around in the cab. So James, if you'd like to hold F. There you go, you can open the firebox and then close it again. So shift F. There you go. And so there you go, James can control the DR1202. If you'd like to move around the cab, James, so like left and right or whatever. There you go. See, James is in control. He's going to have a look around. So this is James's experience course, and it's really triggering me slightly because we're in LNER livery, but, you know, Rick never wore this. It's a fictional loco, so actually suits him all right, apart from the tender, doesn't it?
Yeah, I mean, the tender doesn't look too bad. Ooh,
that valve gear, that view, innit?
Yeah.
So without further ado, I will probably be having to use the F5 HUD a little bit just to keep an eye on the water, but I'll let you, like, using the cab view anyway, show everybody, if we move the camera this way like that, I'm just going to turn the sound down on DR1202 for a minute, because I'm going to try and dampen her down so she's not blowing off the entire time. So if I just turn sound down. No. There we go. So the sounds at the lowest they can be for a minute, because we've all heard DR1202 anyway, but I'm just going to turn off that. So the path is all set, James. So what are you going to be controlling? Are you going to be doing reverser, regulator, and brakes, I assume?
Yep, I can do all those.
Cool beans. I'm just going to turn up your volume a little bit, actually.
Hold it. I'm going to chuck my phone off the bed so it doesn't make a weird noise.
Okay, you'll have to probably speak up a little bit as well, because if it's on voice detection, it cuts out a little.
Yeah, my Discord is at Discord o'clock.
In Discord o'clock. Anyway, so without further ado, whichever way you want to drive, James, yeah, stick them in gear and have a go. I'll do wingmanning stuff as well, so I'll be letting you know where we're stopping. Are we doing a stopping train, or are we just gonna go like semi-fast? Because semi-fast would require us only stopping at Ringwood. And just outside of Brockenhurst for the token exchange, or you can do an all-stopping service if you want.
I'll probably go over semi-fast and just blow the whistle. Yeah, so, shall we get ready to run?
Yep, so if you'd like to release the brakes. As I say, I'll turn the sound back up later.
Yeah, I believe we're at 21. Come on, go into running.
There you go.
It's going to move the camera view.
Yeah, okay.
To...
You wanted it at the wheels front. You wanted it at the front on the other side, didn't you? With the light. Keep going. Another one. One more. There you go. I'd say once he's stopped blowing off, we'll put the sound back up so you can listen to the whistle a bit more. But again, because of the way that TS works and puts engines right at blowing off pressure all the time, unfortunately it blows off a lot. So you might want to thrash it a little bit once we get out of the station area.
Yep, I'm just going to come back in the cab.
Turn the sounds up a little. Sorry, I'm just turning the sounds up
a
little bit.
That's fine, mate, don't worry.
There we go, because I'll dampen him down. So we're also going to find out today whether James is a competent driver. Hooray!
Tom, I think we know the answer to that already.
I thought love was the answer. Hang on.
Doesn't that mean you're fucked?
I think it does, actually.
Oh no! Come on, Ricardo. Did you just give the whistle a little blow there, mate?
I did just give the whistle a little blowy there.
Cheeky.
Cheeky. Oh, you'll love that. You cut the... Yeah, with the paintball whistle, you have to hold it for a while to get them full length, because it just went... There you go. That's better.
Yeah.
That was kind of funny, when it was just like... And then stopped. Oh, we're going under the fly under, by the way. We'd attract it down and then back up again.
Yeah.
So you'll if you look backwards in a sec after we've gone under the bridge. Now look back. You can see how the line the track sort of goes under and then up again.
Yeah, that is pretty. Hello, Rick.
Hello.
You are now the pride of the LNER.
Uh oh.
Dinky.
Uh oh, smelly.
Come on, Rick.
You need to bring the reverser down a bit. Not the reg, the reverser. Yeah, 50% should be enough, and then just floor it.
Punch it.
Punch it. Bear in mind, I put more coaches on so we can thrash him.
Yeah. Ooh.
I love this sound set. When it gets to 25 miles an hour, no coughing on the footplate, you might have COVID.
It's not COVID, it literally showed up last night and I don't have any other symptoms.
Oh, fair enough. Well, I've had a cold, so, you know, and so is Tracy and everything, so, oh well. So, yeah, we are, where are we now? If you cross over to the other side of the cab in a moment, and then keep going. Right there. You'll see in a minute, we're about to pass through a halt that never was, because... Being a fictionalised version of a real route, the only stations that existed properly on this line were Broadstone, Wimborne, which we've just been at. This station we're going through now, as you'll see, is actually in the village of Canford, and it's known as Canford Bottom, the area. So we put a little request stop halt here called Canford Bottom.
Just blasting through.
There we go. Just because this station never had a platform or anything, I just thought it would be a nice little touch just to make the route look a little bit more different.
Reminds me a little bit of station...
Erdington Hall?
No, actually. On the Cambridge to Newmarket line, there is a station called 6 Mile Bottom.
Bottom.
Oh,
ah, like now, as you can see, James, if you look at the boiler pressure level on the top left, you see how it's gone down now.
Yeah.
That's good. That's what we need it to be at, about 240. So if you want to notch the reverser back one, there, a bit more. A bit more. There you go. 37%. And what I will do is, I don't really need pressure yet, so we're good for the time being, because it's more or less flat. There's a bit of uphill after Westmoors. And then we need to slow down before Ashley Heath, but I'll tell you where that is. So at the moment, we're good. We're doing double line speed, so it's all good. Fingers, thumbs up.
This is what Rick bit.
Yeah, what we're doing now, we're going... Well, did you just see the whistle sign? Oh, there's a whistle sign, James.
Oh, no, I didn't.
Well, there you go. Look, there it is. So we need to whistle again. There you go. And this is another fictional station. This is Ringwood and Stape Hill.
Hello, Ringwood.
Not Ringwood, sorry. Ferndown and Stape Hill. another fictional station that in the fictional preserved history of this railway, this was built before the line got to Wimborne as part of the extension, so they had a station to be able to run around that before they pushed on with the extension to Canford Bottom and Wimborne. But we'll cover the fictional history within the channel at some point anyway, I reckon.
Yeah.
Let's see, how we're doing for boiler pressure. Okay, what we need to do is... we need to notch down again, James, if you can. There you go. And I need to probably start firing.
Yeah, I'll rein the reg in a bit just to preserve some pressure.
Yeah, well, we don't need to worry about too much about pressure at the moment because we don't want to be blowing off, but...
Yeah. Oh, I've just seen the water level.
Oh, yeah, I better do that.
0.33%.
0.33.
Yeah, sorry. Didn't want to panic you there.
No, that's fine. I'm keeping an eye on the water and everything anyway, so you just concentrate on driving and try not to get the frames to go blah, 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 like they are right now.
Yeah.
Suddenly the frames went... Yeah, like...
Right.
We can thrash it a little bit for a minute, but in a couple of minutes we'll be approaching some housing. We need to slow down a bit to go through Westmore Station because it's the one that's based on Groombridge, so it's got a sharp curve at the end of it.
I am thrashing.
Thrashing along.
Thrash, thrash, thrash.
Thrash, thrash, got a step on the thrash. Meow!
And that's just for you, Andy.
Oh, yeah, because Andy was talking to us earlier about his the unit he was driving and it wasn't thrashing enough. So I know you haven't really had much of a challenge as of yet, James, because we haven't had any inclines or anything yet, but... What do you think so far of having the ability to drive DR-102, which again, I'll point out, is part of the Patreon perks. By the way, we need to start slowing down now.
Okay.
So, brakes on a bit. You can explain a little bit more, bit more, bit more, bit more, bit more. Right, keep it there for a minute. Anyway, carry on. You, what do you think of having a driver experience course and part of being on the Patreon campaign?
I generally think it's quite good. I really hope I've slowed down enough.
Yeah, you'll probably get a bit of rock going through. I mean, I would go through here at about 30 on a normal day, but it doesn't matter too much.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't even see the whistle.
See what I mean about the curvature there?
Oh, yeah, that was rocky.
Yeah, right, you can take the brakes off again now.
Right, we'll get her back up. Speed.
I'm just going to do a thing quick. I'm just going to grab my headphone controller because what I'm going to do is we're going to come out of the cab. I'm just going to get a panning shot for us. Because you're controlling, I can do it. So.
Yep. I will give the whistle a good blast.
Nice. And you guys can also see the length of the train we're taking.
She is an absolute beast.
Look at that.
I'm just going to open the reg up a bit more to...
Go for it.
Because I see we're losing speed.
Because we're on an uphill bit here. It's uphill from here to Ashley Heath.
Yeah.
Which, fun fact, as I've said before in videos, is where I work, the station.
Barnum's!
There we go, back to the cab we go. On the shadowy side of the cab.
Shit, we're in the shadow realm.
Oh, not again.
Yes, Tom, sorry.
Right, I'm gonna stop firing for a minute.
Yeah, what we at the moment?
220 psi, but because we're injecting, I do not want to be blowing off, because it's downhill to Ringwood from Ashley Heath, and then it's uphill across the common, and then we got a steep downhill bit at Burley Station, and then it's flat until Holmesley, more or less. So, is fine.
Yeah, I think we're off the worst of the incline because I've brought the reg back in.
Yeah.
And we're still accelerating quite nicely.
Huzzah!
Also, looking at the length... Oh,
go on, James.
Yeah. Looking at the length of the train, Rick, you got up to 60, my friend!
Yeah, well, I reckon on them... I mean, we've got something like... I think we've got like 11 or 12 coaches. If we go beyond Brockenhurst onto the main line, I reckon we can probably get up to about 80 or 90.
I think Rick is capable.
He definitely is, because we did... Remember my test run I was doing yesterday before you did this, and... I'm going to mention it because it's funny. Right, James, ease off because we don't brake, but ease off and let us coast a little bit because we'll need to brake a little bit at the station. Funny thing, I took this for the run yesterday before James had done this driving experience course, and I managed to get to Southampton. But as I came into Southampton Central, I was going about 90, and I came over some points really quickly and ended up burying Rick inside a signal box. So that was fun.
He decided to become an interior designer again.
Again. Oh, that's the other thing I better mention as well. The funny thing is something on Rick right now actually suits the LNER livery and the LNER auspices of the design in a way because of it being built by Bear Peacock. James, if you'd like to go round to the front of the loco.
Yep.
And there you go. Look there, everyone. the LNER with fired nameplates. Which I think is a nice little touch for this livery, and also James is probably incredibly happy to see that.
Hi.
Right, we need to break now.
Anchors.
I'm going to say we just like ease on the brake because he's got strong brakes. So, yeah, that'll be fine. Right, oh, we've overfilled with water. Being overly cautious.
Well, you know what that means, Tom.
We're going to be priming. It's going to be the prime time of our lives.
I'm going to thrash her.
I'm going to thrash it.
Right. Yeah, what's the... Should I come off now?
No, keep the brakes on a minute. To be fair, we could probably do it with going a little bit slower, actually. Because as you can see, we're coming up to Ashley Heath. Speed limit here is 15. Right, ease off the brakes now. So we're not stopping here. We're just going to thrash through the station. What I'm going to do quickly while we're here is taking over control of the camera for a sec. I'm just going to get us on the lighter side while we come through. Huh. We both had the exact same idea at that exact same time. We both blew the whistle separately.
Right. I'm
so,
ready to...
As soon as we come off the over the crossing and onto the single track again, you can thrash him again.
Oi!
We did it again! Did you guys see that truck? It literally cannot wait 5 seconds for a really long, heavy train to come through. How rude.
Must be an Amazon delivery driver.
Possibly. Right, open the taps again, James, and move the camera back to where you want it.
Come on, camera.
Come on. Oh, look, I just saw an austerity in the cab.
Where?
Look, right there in front of us. Under the window.
Oh, oh shit!
Funny! Nope. So we're going through the village of, the outskirts of the village of St. Ives and Ashley Heath here, by the way. Just a bit of history again. And then we're going to be going down Hollygrove Bank. Interesting fact for you, actually, James. I've walked this section of this old railway.
Yeah. Oh, Tom, I've run into a problem.
What's that?
There's no Wikipedia article on this engine.
Oh! Ho-ho! Well, there's a... Well, on the DDJP wiki, there's a massive article all about it. I'm going to say, were you ever thinking about doing... I know I've mentioned about Mr. Eden Green doing a project with DR-102, but did you ever think about doing the locos in profile on Rick at some point?
Yeah, I can do a TLF on...
Ricardo Diaz.
Yeah. And just be like, this is Big Boot. I mean, Bob.
This is Big Boob. It has massive, anyway.
Henry slept with my wife.
Boom. Right, we are now on Hollygrove Bank. This is a downhill section, so up to you if you want to, like, 420 blaze it, but we will have to brake set heavily once we start going over the second bridge.
Yeah, I'm just going to ease her back a bit.
Him.
Him, yeah.
He's a man. Oh, cylinder cocks.
Yeah, I just want to get rid of some of that excess water.
Ah, fair enough.
Also, just listen to that.
All it sounds like to me. Don't worry about the water level. We'll let it drop a little bit.
Who is it?
But yeah, it's interesting to note, like, as I say, this section of the route we're running on right now, me and my partner have actually walked all the way from that last station, Ashley Heath, from Ringwood Station area, which is where we're about to get to, over the bridges we're about to cross.
That means I need to... I'm going to...
Well, not yet, don't worry. I would say... I actually put the brakes on a little bit, but not a lot, like maybe getting down to about 17 or 16 inches. Just so that he starts slowing down a little bit as we come across towards the station. No, there you go. Right, a little bit more. There you go, stop. Put it back to... there you go. So, we should slow down now. So, we're going over the bridges. I've realised something. We can actually probably turn the sounds up a little bit now. Hold on 1 second.
Sure thing, mate.
Seeing as he's not blown off. And then we can blow the whistle again. So, off you go, James. Oh, Fez.
She's like, I'll do it. Alright, hello Ringwood.
Okay, change my mind, got to turn the sound back down again. So I realised, like, we've heard Rick a lot before, so yeah. We could probably do with, yeah. Right, yeah, if you need the brakes off again now. Because we've slowed down sufficiently to come across the crossing onto the, into the platform. Because we're going to stop here as well, so.
Yeah, I'll just release the brakes for a minute.
There we go, yeah. Right, we're whistling us. Once you go past this signal, if I just move us over.
Go for it, mate.
Because there should be a whistle board. No, there isn't. So whistle. There we go. And as you can see, that's why we've slowed down. Look at the sharpness here.
Yeah, I'm just going to chuck the brakes on.
You can ease them off again. Brakes are powerful enough. Just getting down to about 10 miles an hour and then... Yeah, we can coast into the station and then we can... Don't need to bother about passengers, really. We just stop here for a minute and then we can carry on. Because I'm going to... I'm hoping that I can get the boiler pressure back down again. Yeah, I've got everything off. There's not really a lot I can do. He's just too efficient. Just casually scare the crap out of everybody on the station. All good?
Yeah. Right, I'll just...
Yeah, chuck him to a stop here, I reckon. He's got plenty of water, so we don't need to top him up yet. Hello, people. How are you doing today?
I'm going to scare the shit out of him. Right.
I've got an idea what we can do here, anyway.
Key.
Oh, hang on. If I move him back to the cab, sorry... Because we're waiting for passengers anyway. What we'll do is we'll put this here, but what I'm going to do is you're going to be in control while we move, and I'm going to try and do one of those like really nice shots of it leaving the station. So why don't you put the camera here? Right, there we go. So, yeah, we'll be able to do a nice visual of him leaving the station whenever you're ready. So
yeah, I'm just putting her into full forward.
Yeah.
Give them a little blast of the whistle.
Release the brakes. And then go chufferoonie. Thrash it! look at all that coming out of the chimney.
I'm just chucking your fire out.
Might as well.
I'll rein her back in a bit.
Alright.
And then I'll get the brakes into running.
I just realised something quite funny, actually.
Yeah.
Because of Rick's wheel arrangement, doesn't he look a lot like a... In LNER livery, he looks a lot like a P2.
Yeah, he does, actually.
On the lower level, anyway. Barnums.
Indeed, Barnum.
And articulated coaches.
Because Rick is in the Arctic Circle.
Funny note. Right, we need to go back to the cab, I reckon.
Yeah.
Because we need to bring the reverser down a bit. He didn't fall forward, so you gotta wait a little. Yeah, there we go. Right, that's 62's alright. Yeah, 62's alright for a minute.
I was just like, I'm just gonna keep tapping S till I can see the bloody thing.
Fair enough. There we go. Right, let's hang on, actually I've got an idea. Instead of going back to the cab, watch this. I'm gonna get the camera because obviously you're driving, so I can do something like this. Hold on. If I can get it to work. If I can get the camera to work, come on. I can do,
tree cam.
No, not tree cam, but like, you know, pacing shot.
Wait, there's a pacer?
Yeah. There you go, look at that. That's good. Well, almost. Okay. If I can get out of the trees!
Right, I'm just going to wind it back in.
There we go.
It's like a little promotional video for Castleman.
Yeah, a little bit.
It's a good thing I whistled when I did.
Oh yeah, we didn't see the
whistle board.
Why are there so many houses? Go away.
I don't know. You built the route.
No, I didn't.
There's a whistle board, Tom.
Yeah, but after the other way. There'll be a whistle board again in a minute. Right, we'll go back to the cab if you want.
Yeah, I think I can see the green thing.
Yeah, there you go. You just passed it, so it's fine.
Give him a little hoot. I'm just going to bring it back a bit more on the reverser.
Yeah.
Going to thrash her a bit more.
I'm going to say, what we're doing now is we're heading up to the common. So we'll be going uphill in a minute after this level crossing, so we need as much power as we can get. So.
Yeah. Come on, Rick.
Come on, Rick. Oh, I swear you're a...
I wonder what we could rhyme Rick with.
Well, there's many things we could rhyme Rick with. Dick, prick, trick, chick. Sick. Oh, Rick is a chick.
Hmm. I'm just going to bring the... Oh, that was a mistake.
Yeah, don't do that. Don't do it!
I'm just trying to get her to go to accelerate again.
Yeah, leave it at 37 for the minute. It could be our pressure dropping a bit. I need to chuck some fire in. I need to chuck some fire in, Nicole.
Ooh, that running gear.
Mmm.
Dada's.
Ow. Right, okay, it's safe up in the cab. We're not gonna get hit by road grass.
Oh, she's accelerating.
I keep calling
ricochet.
I know, it's a force of habit, isn't it? Because we're on a flat bit and then we go uphill again, so this is a perfect opportunity for me too. We should be fine.
Yeah. How's water looking?
55, 54. I'll put some more water in a minute. I wanna wait until we've gotten to the top of this incline.
Yeah, I'm just going to jump over to the other side of the cab real quick.
Uh-huh.
So I keep missing whistle boards.
Well, there's no more crossings until we get to the next station, so you should be good.
Yeah, I just saw a whistle board in the other direction and went, I think I just went across a crossing. Just going to blast my whistle late.
Like this?
Cheeky.
Cheeky whistle on the common.
Come on, Rick. There is fire.
There is a fire. Fire. Da, da, da.
Yes, this fire seems to be made of...
Fire.
Oh, well done, Rick. You're gaining some speed.
He's a powerful boy, eh?
Oh, yeah, he is.
What gradient are we on, actually? Hold on. We are on a 1 in 105 at the moment, so he's not doing too bad, especially considering the length of the train we've got him with.
And considering he has me driving.
Yeah, you're not doing that bad, to be honest. You're doing better than some people have done. I've seen people drive a lot worse.
Hmm. We will mention their names. Crisp! Sorry, what?
Oh, that Crisp kid, though.
I know, right? He's such a Norwegian cunt.
Well, goodbye monetization for this video.
Oh, wait, this isn't for children, so fuck shit, wank box, cunt.
Oh. Okay, no monetization either. Thanks! No, it's fine. It'll be fine. I'll just say it's got some strong language in it. So,
You want me to...
We need to talk French.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Splendor. I'm just going to rein back because I've just seen our boiler pressure.
Yeah, no, don't worry about that because we're at the top of the bank now. So what we need to do is if you ease off the reg, just let him coast.
Have a little rest, Rick.
You can have a rest while we try and get some water in him as well.
Yeah, I completely forgot about the boiler.
No, you don't need to worry about that. I'm managing the boiler and water. It's just I know where we... I always pause when you whistle because I love listening to his whistles. What I'm going to do is... Just shove the handbrake on for a minute just to give us a little bit of slowdown. Actually, I think you might need to put the brakes on a bit.
Brakes are on.
Right.
We have a bridge. It's going to blast.
So, because we at Burley, which is another fictional station, we go into the other loop. So,
What speed do I need to be doing?
Well, we're doing all right. I mean, I think it's like nominal speed limits are about 15, but I think we're probably good. Yeah, we're good.
I've
taken off the brakes, yeah. And then you go back to running. Oh yeah, you whistled at the right time. There's a crossing ahead. See, there you go, foot crossing.
I didn't even notice because I'm on the.
Yeah, but the thing is, you're doing lucky guesses for the whistle boards and things. I'm not even telling you where to whistle, so.
I think it's because I see a bit of green on the other side, so I'm like, I should probably whistle about that.
I see trees of green.
Right, are we ready to thrash, my good sir?
We are ready to rumble again, yes. We've got enough water for a minute.
Punch it.
Well, boiler pressure should go up shortly. I'm just trying to get the fire back to its ideal mass.
Yeah. Yeah, no. It's climbing, so I'm not too worried about it.
Nah, the boiler pressure will go up in its own time. Again, I mean, if Mac boiler pressure is 275, so even at 200 PSI, he's still able to operate pretty coolly. In fact, that's what we normally do. DR drivers usually like to get him down to around between 200 and 230. So we're coming up to a whistle board in a minute, I think, so just keep an eye out.
Yeah, just moving the mouse.
Good thing the viewer can't see the mouse. Yeah. It's actually a big middle finger at this point.
Yeah, I can confirm.
Right, I think we need to whistle now.
Yeah,
I
see it.
Yeah. There you go.
Well done, Rick.
Well done.
His cough showed up last night. It was like, I've not drunk enough.
Oh, mate, I haven't drunk enough yet either.
Nah, but I know it's not the Lurgy.
No, it's not the dreaded, Corona.
Gonna stop, give you, gonna get copyright.
Copyright strike, copyright strike, my coronavirus. Right, okay, so that's the outer distance for Holmesley.
Yeah.
Which, another fun fact, James, is a tea room now, the station.
Ooh.
I've been there once before, it's kind of nice. The interior's all decorated with old photos of the railway.
Let's scare those bastard shitmen.
Let's do it. Everyone drinking tea and eating ham, egg and chips are going to be absolutely terrified shortly. In fact, let me just get the map up for a sec to show you. We are 0.34 from Holmesley Station. So we're not stopping here, but we do need to slow down and stop just outside the station on the other side, because we need to stop for the main line. Because technically speaking, from Holmesley to the Network Rail boundary isn't a proper running line. Like, right, in the history of it, because, like, trains don't usually go any further than Holmesley, unless it's, like, Garner Days or whatnot, or they're running a mainline shuttle. So, we'll come through here. It gives us time as well to get the boiler pressure back up.
Yeah. Plus, I can scare the people.
Yeah.
How's your fucking tea now, bitch?
Tea room's on the other side, mate.
One sec, I'll get there.
There it is. Oh, wait, no, we missed it. Hold on.
God fucking
damn. There
it is. Your fucking feet, bitch.
There we go. Right, I'll get you back on the driver's side.
Yep, I am indeed a driver. And I'm indeed...
So just keep it slow here for a minute.
Yep. I'm reining her in slowly.
There you go. You see the, red signal ahead?
Yes, I do, my good...
There you go, it's just turned green, so we're good to go.
Do you want me to stop?
Yeah, we better.
Anchors, Rick! Just overshot it slightly.
It doesn't matter, the cab hasn't passed it. Let's see, stop, obtain permission before proceeding. So we need to get some permission. Let's see. Hello. Boris Johnson.
Yes. Hello.
Are we allowed to go past this signal of danger?
Yes.
Okay. Cool. Right, James, notch back a bit. Like, don't start off in 100. Go back down to about 65 or something. A bit more. There you go. Right, and then we can go. You need to take the brakes off again.
I do, yeah. That would probably help a bit.
It would. I don't know whether I've taken the handbrake off. Hold on.
Have you?
I think I've just taken it back off.
She wasn't struggling.
Let's find out. Yeah, I did take the handbrake off.
Come on, Rick.
I like listening to him at low speed, like with lower regulator and reverser. He's got a sort of thump to him. In fact, if we go around to the front, bring the reverser back down. A bit more. And then the regulator down a little bit. Can you hear that?
Yeah.
Reg up a little bit. Right, now you can thrash him again.
Punch it.
And then I need you on that side, actually. We're basically just playing Ring Around the Rick at the minute, aren't we?
Pretty much.
Right, pressure's going up nicely, so we're good to go.
Yep, I can see it climbing.
Ideally, what we want is full boiler pressure before we get to the main line, because we need all the power we can get on the main line, because we want to 420 blaze it up to Southampton. Until we get to Millbrook. This time we will brake before when we get near Millbrook, okay?
Yeah. Do we want to stop at... I can't remember what the station's called. Brockenhurst. Do you want to stop there?
Yeah, can do. Yeah, we can stop at Brockenhurst. Give us a bit of it operational interest.
Yeah, just be like, you thought this was a 450.
It's not. If it's a 442, I'd be slightly more interested, though. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Right, so this section line here is technically not part of the main running line because it just connects the Castleman's Railway main up to the main line at Brockenhurst. It's a bit like at Swanage where normal service trains don't go past Norden, but the railway line is still there up to Walgett Junction and onto the Southwest main line. So we're like a slightly different version of that. But at the moment we're on flat ground, but we'll be climbing again in a minute, so...
Yeah, I'm just chucking her up. Chuck it up into the roof to get some power down.
Yeah. And hopefully we should have enough on the firebox for the boiler pressure.
We've got like £900.
Yeah, we should be good. I might chuck a bit more on there just to help out, but...
Yeah, up to you, mate. You're the fireman.
I'm the fireman. No, I'm not. I don't even know how to drive a steam engine. What?
Well, we're fucked.
Just checking something quick. Yeah, sure, we're good. It's alright, I was a bit worried that, I think I might have actually had my volume a bit too high.
She'll be fine.
Yes! microphone volume had been right down this entire time, because you know when you you know when you pressed on we've ruined the video. I might have to edit the end of it.
For fuck's sake.
You know when you took the mouse off me earlier on?
I'm sorry.
You idiot, you've broken this whole drive experience course. So my microphone volume has been right down throughout the, like, more or less entirety of the last half of the... Oh, you know what, it's fine. It's fine, it's all a bit of fun, whatever. So basically, James has ruined the video at the end, so that's all good.
Yay.
And I might end up cutting this video, like, the middle bit out, just so we've got some audio stuff. I'll have a listen later on. But yeah, that was James Wright's experience with driving DR1202. We do apologise if the middle bit gets cut out, but if not, then... you get to listen to just James for a bit. So, thank you everybody for watching. James, thanks for taking part in the Driver Experience course, and I hope you enjoyed yourself.
Definitely, and sorry about fucking with the audio.
You actual plank. Anyway, that's it from us today. We will see you next time. Say goodbye, James.
Goodbye, James.